Hey guys, it's Darcy Simmer and welcome back to my channel. Today I am back with another room makeover. Today I am making over Evie Delgado's room. This house is in Brindleton Bay and I've already made over her brother's room, Pierce. You can see it over there to the side, the little navy blue room. But what was I talking about? Oh yeah, I'll link that in the description if you guys haven't seen it. But today I decided to do his little sister's room, and I don't know why she has such a big room. But she does. Her room's much bigger than her brother's, and I don't understand because she's just a toddler and he's a kid. So, you know, I didn't really understand that, but you know, whatever. But basically, I was looking on Pinterest for some ideas and I came across this image, and that's kind of the idea I went with. I liked the idea of the little fence against the wall, but you know, you can't exactly do that in The Sims. Have a fence over the wall, so I just decided to make a little playpen area that kind of went with that idea. And then there was like a flower on the wall, and the only thing I could think of to make leaves were those two green shelves. So yeah, I kind of like the way it turned out. It's not one of my favorite rooms I've ever built, I'm gonna be honest, but it's not bad. But yeah, I do put a lot of decorations and stuff on the walls because it is a kid's room. I wanted it to be really colorful, even though usually I don't like to use colors, but I decided to go with it in this room because it is a toddler's room, and I just felt like it should be really colorful. So on this wall over here, I do place a lot of pictures and stuff and a lot of wall art, and yeah, I tried those little arrowy things, but there's an idea I want to use with those for like a nursery or something. I don't know, I'll just have to wait and see how it turns out. But this room is on my gallery if you guys would like to download it. It is called Evie Delgado bedroom or something. Hang on. Evie Delgado room reno is what it's called, and it is 14,370 simoleons. It is a 9x7 room. I'm not sure what size that is equivalent to on the gallery, because you can filter it small, medium, or large. I think it might be a large room because it is a pretty good sized room, but I'm not 100% sure. But anyway, it is filtered under kids rooms. So yeah, you can do that, or you can just type in my origin ID and it'll be in there somewhere under rooms. My origin ID is in the description if you guys don't know it. It is not the same as my YouTube channel. So yeah, just be sure to check that and double check it, because there are a lot of numbers in it. But yeah, just copy and paste. That's what I usually do. But yeah, over here is the little playpen area. I really liked it. I put some sunflowers in there because I don't know, I thought it'd be cute. I don't really know that they go with the rest of the room. I mean, flowers are flowers, I guess. But yeah, I did use a lot of little stuffed animals and stuff. I resized the creepy ones and stuck one up there on the shelf, and then another one next to the cat one because I thought they were really cute sized down. And yeah, I just thought they were really cute. But there's a lot of toys all over this bedroom, and I did resize a lot of them, which kind of look weird whenever your Sim plays with them. But yeah, so that's unfortunate. But yeah, I don't think she'd actually be able to get to the ones on the shelves though, so if you want her to be able to play with those, you'll just have to drag them and drop them into the toy box or something. But yeah, other than that, everything should be okay. But the toys that I place around the toy box and stuff, your Sims will pick those up if you have free will on. Yeah, they'll just go around and clean them and just stick them in the toy box. So those probably won't last very long. But yeah, same with the big ones, which will look kind of weird because they'll be carrying these giant toys around, but it'll still look like they're carrying the normal sized ones around. But yeah, it's fine. It's fine. And then I did place a lot of rugs because, I don't know, I just thought it was really cute just having a bunch of different sized flowers all over the floor. Yeah, I liked it. I thought it was cute. If you guys don't like it, feel free to get rid of them. But yeah, I wanted the wall to kind of look like a sky, but I wanted there to be a green color on the bottom, but they don't have them. For some reason, they have like the reversed, I guess it's an ombre color wall or something, but they have like a green on top and a blue on bottom, and that's not what I was looking for. But yeah, I just went with whatever I thought would go with it. So there was like this one, and there was another option where it was orange on bottom. I thought about maybe using that, but yeah, I just decided to go with the light blue and dark blue one instead. But you know, you guys can feel free to change that if you'd like. But yeah, that's just what I went with because I thought it looked like a sky, you know? I guess the orange could also look like a sky, like a sunset or something. But yeah, that's what I decided to go with. And I like the way the room turned out for the most part. I just feel like there's too much going on. I'm not really a fan of color. But yeah, like I said, it was a toddler's room, so I felt like there had to be a lot of color. And I guess it's kind of spring theme or something. But yeah. I mean, it's kind of cute. It's cute for a kid's room. But yeah, there's just a lot of color. There's a lot going on. So that part I'm not too thrilled about. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's not the worst room I've ever made, probably, but yeah. But here are the screenshots, so thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, or subscribe if you haven't already, and let me know whose bedroom you would like to see me make over next. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!